On GitHub. I was going to ask the same question, so let me just enjoy using his question. I was going to ask about the MIT, like, which license you have, like, in your MIT, Open Access, because you said someone can adapt your code to web application, but the license of the code is going to create, let's say, a problem, because in MIT, you can do whatever you want, as long as you do the reference. Which license you have in your GitHub?
But you can
Do you know?
always, for example, you can always branch from a no. You can always choose like the my yeah. We can try to check what
No,
the license.
yes. The rule of GitHub, if you don't put any license, GitHub will say that all the rights is yours. So no one can use it according to the rule of GitHub. The person can fork. They can fork, but they cannot say use your
I have
code.
for the vaccination, I have a GNU General Public License version 3.0, and the same
So
for
that's
the.
good. That's good, GNU license, right? Well, that's good. That's a perfect license. That's one of the
For
best.
both, for both, so for both studies that I presented, both packages they have. If you share my screen, I can show actually
Yes,
the.
I'm sharing screen. Okay, I'm sharing screen. They are seeing your screen. The only problem with the GNU license is that the code is a contagion license. It means that when you use a GNU, you should must as well make your software GNU. So it's a contagion license, they call it. It's a contagious.
Okay, yeah. So you have to sort of inherit. So I don't know. Did you share the screen or?
Yes, I'm sharing the screen.
Yeah. So this is GitHub, and then this is project which was called COVID-19 vaccination, and this was about and this was COVID schools. So it has basic. Actually, this one I would actually suggest maybe looking first at this COVID-19 schools because it has Yeah, it has some overview, like where it was published. It was also what the data we used, for example, for the seroprevalence data, the contact matrices that we used, the demographic data, etc. It has how the model inference or this parameter inference was done, and so on. So I mean, doesn't have too much information, but has basic information that is necessary. And then you have, for example, this. In the scripts, you have the scripts that are used to estimate the model parameters, actually, and these are the scripts, and they are coded in R, actually, as you can see. And then you have the model itself, which is the analysis of the model. That's notebooks, for example, school analysis. And for the other one, it's quite similar. It's quite similar description was the data and so on. And the data, I think I even included all the figures that I'm showing and so on. So. Yeah, so feel free to use, and maybe we can talk later at some point later how we can. Oh,
Hey guys.
sorry. Oh, sorry.
Hey guys. For it goes not just to my YouTube channel Biomathematics, it goes well to my tube of computer programming of web development. I have two channels, so I'm gonna post part. See that you have all this amazing code by Professor Gunnar Rusnova. It's a GNU license, meaning that you can use. So if you want to develop a web application, use Biomathematics. I launched a course about Biomathematics and web development. The challenge that we as a web development, I'm a web developer as well, we should as well use Biomathematics to innovate. My course is called Innovative Biomathematics because we need to do web application for your code. So see all those amazing codes by Professor Gunnar Rusnova, all of them under the GNU license. It means that you can use it. I mean, as
Yeah,
long as you keep yours GNU as
that's
well.
the point. That's why I'm putting it there so that people can also see and check, and maybe somebody has better idea and writes to me like he has some other ideas or he, I don't know, spotted something that is strange and he wants to ask me. So I want to share. I think also during this pandemic, it's important to share what you're doing so that people can evaluate it and think for themselves. Yeah.
Yes, but what I like the most on your talk, and you repeat that again, is because you made available code on GitHub. Some times ago, I remember in my PhD, I asked the code to someone, they said, I cannot send the code. Some years ago, like 3 years ago, I could not get the code for no one. But in your case, you
That's
made the
true.
code available. I mean, because, I mean,
I regret that some of my it was not like that you don't want to share, but I think that it was still not so open access. you know, the publications were also not open access. Many of them you just publish and then people can't read it actually because they were not, they can't open them. They're not free, for example. And I regret very much because sometimes when I want to check something that I have done in the past, instead of going to GitHub and opening, now I have to search on my hard drives where was that, you know, something, some analysis that I did in the past. So. But yeah. I hope that it will change because overall, I think the community is changing. There is much more desire to do everything open access. And there is actually, it's a requirement. In many journals nowadays, you cannot submit or publish a publication if your data is not open access. They're just not going to do it. They say, well, yeah, we base it on the data that is not open to others so that people can't check it. We also cannot publish it. Because nobody can verify what you have done. So that's good.
It happened for me. I tried to publish a paper recently in my second postdoc, and the review asked for what is the GitHub? In my case, it was I developed the web application. The other research developed the computer simulation, computational biology part. My part was on GitHub, but their part was not GitHub. So the review asked, what is the GitHub? So they had to put the GitHub in order to get the paper published.
Okay. Okay.
So guys, just to close, because Professor Gana has to leave, it was a wonderful talk. I'm talking about the JavaScript developers. I'm reading a book about JavaScript and artificial intelligence. It's a deep learning book. So as you can see, JavaScript can make very heavy calculations. So I believe you take the code of Professor Gana under the GNU license, can be very easy for you to adapt. I mean, not easy, but you have to work a little bit, but you can adapt. It's GNU license, all the hard work she already did, she already published the paper. So you can make your website to make computer simulation using COVID.
Yeah, maybe you can make it more efficient. I'm not a computer scientist. I know that sometimes, for example, people can do more like more efficient code and so on. So, but that would be nice.
You did the hardest part. The hardest part is the mathematics. So now when you make the web development, just a matter of computer programming. I mean, you already have the code, you already have the theory, the paper. So you can just publish your sites and make people go there, make simulation, then always remember to make the reference. I mean, it's a GNU license, but you still have to make the reference to the paper. I mean, not. I don't think that you still, but you should. I mean,
Okay.